there today.
Yes, they do.
Big time green.
Alex Long will jump center against the Conference Player of the Week, Dominique Elliott. Hawks will go left to right in the opening half as everybody gets their matchups all set. And the referees make sure the floor is clean and okay. I think somebody picked up something for just a moment. Looks like we're good to go. Hawks and Spartans tonight from Maryland Eastern Shore. Dominique Elliott wins the opening tip, and away we go in a hotly contested game. Martin on the right wing looks to Shane Randall in the corner as things get underway. Shane throws it deep into the forecourt where Rivera almost went into the backcourt. But he corralled it in time and goes to the left. Decides to go against his own defense, bouncing into the low post, threading the needle to Randall, who finished at the rim.
Nice pass, good assist, great start for Randall down in the block.
Randall already on the scoreboard. He doesn't get there very often, but a good physical post player, and the Hawks are going to need him tonight. Spurlock and Frost both unavailable as Norfolk State starts things with a beautiful alley-oop from Zaina Robinson to Alex Long on the back door to tie things at two. Robinson staring down the Hawks fans as he runs back up the floor.
The freshman Long with a alley-oop to begin the basketball game.
Martin drives baseline left side for the Hawks, missed it over the top of the rim. Long comes down with the rebound. Here comes Short in transition the other way, and Martin gets called for a foul in the backcourt. 1 minute and 1 second into the ball game.
That's not good at all. The wasted foul. Got tangled up in the backcourt, right in front of the referee. Not a good way to start for Devin.
So Devin's got to be careful now moving forward. If he picks up a second foul, he'll likely sit. Coach Collins has not been afraid to pull any of his star players, whether it's Copeland, Elliott, or Martin, if they pick up early fouls. Robinson circling through the right side, and he is blocked by Randall's right elbow. Here comes Copeland the other way. He's got a disadvantage, but muscles his way to the rim, and he's hacked. Bakari Copeland flexing his right bicep as he comes up. Pretty jazzed up.
His left bicep was the one that held the defense off. Strong to the basket for Bakari Copeland. Probably the best physical specimen on the Hawks basketball.
I agree with you. Dominique Elliott is probably the best overall athlete because of his length and his agility for being a big guy. But Bakari Copeland is the guy you look at and you think, yeah, okay, that's a true basketball player, yeah, at its truest sense. Yeah. He hits the first free throw, 3-2 UMES. Maryland Eastern Shore lost their first home game of the season to Fairfield, but they've won six straight since then. And Copeland hits both free throws to give the Hawks a 4-2 lead. We're just over 1 minute in. Norfolk State working right to left here in the opening half. Robinson in the forecourt. The sophomore Georgia native passes to Short on the right. Makes a shimmy move on Martin. Passes up to Long. Fakes from outside the right elbow. Back to Short. Three right corner. Splash. 5-4 Norfolk State.
With confidence and serious backspin on that jump shot, the net almost came down.
I'll tell you what, Norfolk State looks a little more ready to go tonight than Hampton did on Saturday. Here's Rivera up top to Devin Martin. Devin lobs to Randall, right side of the key. Shane's a big player today. Maybe got away with a push-off. Missed the layup. Elliott the putback. 6-5 UMES.
I think he may have got away with a push-off. But we'll take that bucket. Good follow-up.
Robinson a jump pass to the right side of the floor where Long holds right around his waist and then puts it on the deck. Two screeners on the right side. It frees up Robinson. He'll dribble back to the top of the arc. Lost it momentarily. Crossed up Thomas Rivera, 10 to shoot. Right wing, Taylor. Faked a three, drove the lane, and got hit. Who's the foul on?
They're both teams.
It's on Bakari Copeland, his first. Team
both
second.
Both teams coming out with a lot of enthusiasm to begin this game. And Norfolk State should be ready for us. I mean, they can read the papers. They can watch the ESPN scroller. They know what we did on Saturday. So they're here to play. Both teams play. We're going to be in for a heck of a game.
These are two of the hottest teams in the conference. First free throw up and in to tie the game at 6 apiece. Technically, the Hawks with their 4-game winning streak and Bethune-Cookman, who's got a 3-game winning streak, are the two hottest teams. Second free throw rattled away, no good. 6-6 tie, 2.5 minutes in. But Norfolk State has won 5 of its last 6 games, and they are playing good basketball. Here's Elliott finding Randall. Step back, 3 right wing, you betcha! Shane Randall doesn't shoot many, but he put it in. Only his second career three-pointer.
That's a plus for the Hawks. Randall with 5 points to begin the basketball game.
9-6, UMES, 3 minutes in. His short puts up a bomb of a three and missed it. But the putback from Butler, good from right under the cylinder. 9-8.
Yeah, Butler about 6'6", 210. A very good rebounder for the Norfolk State Spartans.
UMES with a one-point edge, 16:45 left opening half. Rivera, the point guard, going to play a lot of minutes. He bounces toward the top of the arc. Elliott holds it. Dom feeds the low post back to Randall. Now out to Copeland, right wing. Once again, posting up Randall. It was thrown toward the right corner, deflected and saved before it went out of bounds by Norfolk State. In transition, short right wing three, and he got it again. Devin Martin couldn't contest the shot the way he wanted to because of the early foul he picked up 1 minute in. Instead, Short has 2 threes already. It's 11-9, Norfolk State.
And we might need to pick him up just over half court.
Martin holding the ball, pestered up top, gives away to Rivera. Thomas tries the right half of the floor, 4 minutes into the game. 9 seconds on the shot clock. Rivera circles back, feeds Elliott. A power dribble, he forced it up, and he got hit. Wow. Long cannot believe it. Elliott happy that the foul was called. That's the second foul on Alex Long in the opening 4 minutes of the game. So Long may not be a big factor here in the first half either. First media timeout. It's Norfolk State 11, Maryland Eastern Shore 9. This is the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
The Courtyard by Marriott on Route 13 in Salisbury offers comfortable rooms and meeting spaces, as well as always superior customer service in a great location near the mall. Call 410-742-4405 and ask for details about their special UMES athletics rate. The Courtyard by Marriott in Salisbury, an official hotel of UMES Athletics and a proud sponsor of Hawks basketball from sfmsports.net.
We now pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is UMES Basketball on the Hawks Sports Network from sfmsports.net.
Maryland Eastern Shore trails 11-9 after our first media timeout early in the first half this evening. Norfolk State in town for the only matchup between the two teams in the regular season as Dominique Elliott heads to the free throw line. Well, the Hawks, since the turn of the calendar year, have been so much better from the stripe as Elliott's first free throw is up and short. In fact, Maryland Eastern Shore has relied heavily on Elliott himself. Dominique entered tonight's game 39 of his last 51. That's 76% from the free throw line. He's brought his season average up to 68% with that 76% margin over the last 9 games. The Hawks have shot it better than 80% 5 times in the first 9 games of the 2016 calendar year. Elliott splits the pair. It's 11-10, Norfolk State. On the right wing, catch and shoot three from Taylor. Short. Elliott rips away the rebound. Taylor, one of the veterans on this team that they'll heavily rely on, along with Jeff Short. Ryan Andino into the ballgame early on. Here's Dante Caldwell as well. Copeland has it right wing, finds Caldwell in the corner. Dante tiptoes on the baseline, forced it up. It did not spin in. Caldwell disappointed with that, but he draws contact. So it's the third foul on Norfolk State. And it's the first foul on Deshaun Taylor. So Dante Caldwell will go to the stripe. It'd be great to see him have a big opportunity. I'd like to think that when Caldwell was on the bench and saw Martin pick up that first foul 1 minute into the game, as he ties it here with that free throw, That's probably Dante's mental cue.
Get ready.
All right, let's go. Dante has typically been the third player off the bench behind Andino and Peck. And he hits both free throws here. The freshman off to a good start. A couple of 20-point games this year. He is a capable scorer. Hawks lead by one. Short on the left wing. He dribbles back toward the top of the arc. Short picks up the dribble, pisses left side. Robinson gives into the high post with jump shot coming. Missed, tip back up and in from Butler.
Butler.
Taylor didn't hit it, but Butler finished.
Butler very well, plays very well around the basket.
6'6", 245, he's a big kid. Andino on the left wing finds Rivera, who is open for a moment. Penetrates, drives back to Andino, who banked in a three. 15-13.
We'll take that.
That's right. Charles Oliver in the left corner. I think he stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, sure did.
Here's Derek Opeck to replace Bakari Copeland for the moment.
And some guys getting in the game a little bit earlier than normal for Coach Collins. He's got to figure out how to make up for the little bit of loss to Frost for because of a knee injury.
Charles Oliver, a redshirt senior from Scotch Plains, New Jersey, and a transfer from Robert Morris, a very talented senior. Rivera has it up top for the Hawks and goes left side to Caldwell. He'll feed Elliott, baseline, turnaround, no. Peck could not corral the putback as he tried to jam it home, running down the lane. Here comes Norfolk State down by two. Baseball toss to the right side where Oliver feeds Taylor up top. Back to Robinson, left wing, and they'll set something up. Robert Jones, the head coach, barking out to his offense. Here's Robinson and Taylor exchanging passes as Peck almost jarred it loose. Robinson for three, right wing, yes. Holds three up in the air, and he dabs as he runs back up the court.
Profiling 16-15. Going down the court. Sometimes that may not work out in the long run.
Andino in the forecourt as Norfolk State's already connected on three of four from long range. Into the right wing. Elliott finds Caldwell. Wide open right corner three. As pure as you can shoot it. 18-16. Caldwell's got five early on.
Perfect.
13-35 left in the opening half. Robinson between the circles. Throws a pass to his left side. Conference preseason player of the year, Jeff Short, wants it in the corner. He got it. He shot it. He made it. Unbelievable. Three threes already. That kid's on fire. 19-18 Norfolk State. Rivera in the forecourt, looking around as some of the crowd begins to murmur here inside the Heights Center.
Oh, they're seeing a shooting expedition to start out.
Thomas Rivera has it on the right side. Gets a screen from Elliott, passes left wing with 10 to shoot. Rivera found Peck underneath. It was slapped away out of bounds. Stays with the Hawks.
Rivera had Elliott buried deep on the post and could not get in the basketball.
Robinson and Taylor both check out. Preston Bungie and who else checked in? Devontae Banner. They both come in. Here's Peck on the inbound in the left corner. Finds Rivera. Five to shoot. Up top to Caldwell. NBA deep three. Rattled out. No good. Rebound lost out of bounds. It clearly went off two Norfolk State players. Yeah. And the referees are going to come over and make sure that gets put back the other direction. There was nobody else over there. Well, we're going to see a very interesting opportunity here for Mark Seelan.
Right.
Seelan does not get a lot of playing time because he's essentially the third point guard on the team. He replaces Thomas Rivera here, who played the first 7 minutes of the ball game. Seelan is in only for the second time since the Pittsburgh contest. And Dante Caldwell traveled with it on the left wing.
Yeah, a little running start that time by Dante. Just to calm down a little bit, Dante. He's going to be playing a lot of minutes today, I believe.
19-18 Norfolk State. Jeff Short clapping his hands on the offensive end. He's feeling it. He's already got 9 points on three triples. He'll work against Caldwell, one of the better athletes for the Hawks. Gets a screen, Short to the top of the arc. Looks into the paint, found some help underneath. A turnaround bucket and a foul from Jordan Butler.
He's going to have a hard time handling him down inside with his width. He's about 6'6", 245, and takes up a lot of space in there. Use his body well. Backed his man down, off the glass for two.
I'll tell you what, I like this Norfolk team, man. They play with some serious swag.
Yeah, it's serious.
There's a lot of confidence. Deshaun Taylor checks back into the game. Jeff Short catches his breath. Butler's free throw is up and popped out. It missed a little short. 21-18 Norfolk State. 12:25 left in the first half as Peck and Elliott help break the press for an Andino right wing three. Yes! Ryan Andino pounds his chest as he ties the game. A lot of cheering now after a fairly quiet crowd for the women's game earlier. They are rocking inside the Hype Center now.
Thanks to Norfolk State getting them riled up.
21 all, 8 minutes in. On the right side, Bungie up top. Banner wants to make his way through the paint. He beat him off the dribble. Ryan Andino commits the foul. And we've got a free throw coming. Devontae Banner, the sophomore from Mount Vernon, New York, will head to the line when we come back. Andino, his first, team fourth. Timeout on the floor, 21-21 ball game, 11:54 to go. You're listening to the Hawk Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
Hey fans, have you heard that UMES is trying to raise $48,000 in just 48 hours? You heard me right, 48 grand in 48 hours for UMES, here to support your athletic and academic programs. So please be prepared to make a difference this homecoming, February 19th through February 21st.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the Bay. While taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset, it's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
Hey, Hawks fans, this is Derek O'Peck, senior guard. Thanks for listening to Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball. This is Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
I want to make a quick correction here as we get back to action. 21-21. I have two things to update you on. The first one, Mark Seelan actually has played in only one game since Old Dominion, not since Pittsburgh. He played against Howard a week ago tonight, but that was his first game since Old Dominion. Devontae Banner's at the free throw line after Ryan Andino's first personal foul, and he missed the free throw. The other thing, I apologize. I was mispronouncing this player's last name. It's Preston Bungay. We won't continue to mispronounce that, so sorry about that. 21-21, second free throw up. It also missed. Banner misfired on both. This is the best free throw shooting team in college basketball. Andino for another three. Missed it left. Rebound tipped several times, and the Spartans come away with it. Green and gold into the forecourt on the right wing, and a either an offensive foul or a travel. What do we have?
Wow, on Butler, probably.
I believe it is. Lots of whistles blowing. Still waiting for the official signal. Yep. Butler cleared somebody away illegally. His first, team fourth. We've got a lot of subs. Isaac Taylor, Shane Randall, Bakari Copeland, Devin Martin, and Mark Seelan are now the five on the floor for UMES. They have the ball offensively, tied at 21. Both teams with two fouls to give left here in the first half.
Coach Collins got everybody on the bench active so far.
Seelan, the native of Paris, France, weaves it around, goes to the left side of the floor, wants Bakari Copeland to come back toward him. Mark on the right wing, looks into the paint. 12 to shoot, gets a screen from Randall. Seelan passes to Copeland, left wing, back to Mark. Up top, three ball, just off to the left. Rebound to Jordan Butler. Not a great shot, but it was open. Here we go. Oliver has it left side for Norfolk State. Oliver is a very dangerous shooter. Working against Isaac Taylor. That means there's a mismatch underneath. Martin against Butler. Here's Oliver, who stutters, fades away from the right elbow, missed it short. And Isaac Taylor grabbed the rebound while taking an elbow to the forehead. Martin into the forecourt, gives back to Mark Seawin as the dangerous Jeff Short waits at the scorer's table for Norfolk State. 21-21, 10:40 left opening half. Seawin runs the point with Thomas Rivera waiting patiently on the bench. Seawin through the left side, looking into the post. A bad pass. Taylor re-corralled it in just before it went out of bounds. He threw it up top to Martin, who jump stops into the paint. Layup blocked by Butler. Here comes Norfolk State. Oliver hip for hip with Copeland. It's spun high off the rim. Bakari may have gotten just a brief hand on it and altered the shot. It was missed on the layup, and then a Norfolk State foul on the rebound. How about that?
Yeah, what a good hustle and good rebound in traffic.
Devontae Banner missed the layup as Short replaces Oliver.
And Norfolk goes back in their patented 3-2 zone. Then they match up out of that.
We'll see Jonathan Wade enter in just a moment. 21-21 game. Seawin on the left side gives to Bakari Copeland. Randall has it high post. They work back around to the right wing for the Hawks at the 10-minute mark of the first half. Mark Seawin gets a high screen from Isaac Taylor. Does not use it. Gives up to Martin. Low right post extended. Randall backing down. Martin to Seawin into the corner for an open Copeland three. Missed it long. Rebound pulled in by Devontae Banner. Here comes Norfolk State.
Great reversal of the ball.
Taylor got fouled on the way up before he darn near ripped the rim off the backboard on what would have been a ridiculous slam dunk. Thankfully, it wasn't.
That'll get the crowd stirred up.
They're stirred up at the thought of what almost happened. Taylor showing his athleticism. Deshaun Taylor, a senior and a native of the Bahamas. We've seen a lot of good college basketball players lately come from the Bahamas. Buddy Hield, the second leading scorer in the country, and the superstar player at Oklahoma, who right now might be the player of the year in college basketball. He's a Bahama native, as is Tum Tum Nair from Michigan State. We saw him earlier this year.
Yeah, I watched the Hereford play several times on TV. He's the real deal.
Taylor cans them both. 23-21, Norfolk State. Maryland Eastern Shore has the basketball with Mark Seawin running the point. Jeff Short tries to rile up his defense. We have seen Jonathan Wade come into the ballgame now for the first time. We'll see what the Hawks can do with Seawin running the point as Rivera goes back to the scorer's table. Taylor, the freshman big fella, on a pick and roll, doesn't get the pass. Instead, Martin has it right corner. Devin goes back to Seawin. Mark tried to pass it, a bounce pass into the paint. It's tipped around a few times and apparently off Norfolk State, out of bounds. It stays in the forecourt, right sideline inbound for UMES.
It was off Robertson's foot. Hawks caught a break that time because Norfolk was on a break.
Rivera and Elliott back on the floor for Seawin and Taylor. Each team with five fouls at the 9:17 mark. Possession arrow favors Norfolk State as one of the officials goes over and squares something away. Hawks get a fresh clock. Rivera at the point, and I think there was a clock malfunction. So we'll have to restart that play in just a moment.
Yeah. 15 seconds, they moved it down to 15 on the shot clock. 9:13 left in the first half.
So now there's 11 seconds on the shot clock since four had ticked off when it was put back up to 30. But you're right, when the ball's kicked out of bounds, they reset it to 15. So now 10 to shoot. Martin has it on the right wing, looking up top to Thomas Rivera. Rivera gets a screen, jump stops, throws it up top. Elliott goes over to Martin, who fades away, chucks it up because he had to, and missed the three from the right side. Hawks offensively don't really have it together right now. Taylor fakes, kicks out to Robinson. Robinson tries the left side of the floor, crossed up Rivera and passed back up top to Jeff Short. All-conference player a year ago, drives the right side, high off the window, no. A little out of control there. Elliott the rebound. Hawks are running. Rivera finds Randall on the run and threw it behind him. They doinked off his right shoulder out of bounds.
It's about a fourth possession in a row that we have not gotten a shot off on the offensive end.
You wonder if maybe part of it was Mark Seawin being the point guard. They just don't have a lot of the chemistry with him yet. But once Rivera's come back in the ballgame, the Hawks hopefully will find a little more rhythm on the offensive side. 23-21 Norfolk State. 8:28 left in the first half. Spartans are the best three-point shooting team in the conference. Jeff Short holds the ball. He's already hit three triples tonight, three of the team's four. Into the left corner. Bungay drives the baseline, lost it out of bounds, saved it just in time toward the corner. Four to shoot, on his way to the rim, missed the layup. Wade couldn't connect. Here come the Hawks running the other way. Copeland into traffic. Jumped, lobbed it up top just so he maintained possession. And UMES will slow up what was an ugly transition play.
A lot of activity, a lot of pace, but not good basketball from both teams over the last couple months.
It doesn't seem like there's been much of a plan. Just sort of go out and play.
Run.
Here's Rivera for three. It's a deep one. Swirls around, no. Elliott, the offensive board. He muscles his way up. Lost the ball, and then it went out of bounds off the Hawks. Timeout on the floor, 7:40 left in the first half, and the visiting Norfolk State Spartans lead it 23-21. Back in a moment. This is the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Every golfer wants to play better golf. Whether it's fixing a slice off the tee or learning how to accurately read a green, there's always room to make your game just a little bit stronger. The key to better golf is the best instruction, and Golf Digest is the only place you can learn from the game's hottest pros. Ernie Els, Phil Mickelson, Tiger Woods, and many more. Subscribe today, and for just $14.97, you'll get 12 issues of Golf Digest with easy-to-follow tips and techniques, reviews of top equipment, information on the best places to play, even our quick reference pocket tips in every issue. Order Golf Digest now, and we'll send you a DVD featuring renowned instructor Jim McLean. It's absolutely free with your paid subscription. Learn Jim's favorite drills to help isolate your problem areas and practice plans that will help fine-tune your game. Subscribe to Golf Digest today for this limited-time DVD offer. Call 800-248-5568. That's 800-248-5568 to get your subscription to Golf Digest. 800-248-5568.
How you doing? This is Devin Martin, senior guard from Maryland Eastern Shore, and you're now tuning in to Hawks Sports Network.
Well, UMES and Norfolk State just played a pretty sloppy 4 minutes of basketball. The Hawks' last basket came 5 minutes ago on Ryan Andino's three-pointer. Norfolk State's last basket came 6 minutes ago on Jeff Short's three-pointer. The Hawks have missed their last five threes in a row. The only points we had between media timeouts were the free throws as the media timeout on the front end expired. So it's 23-21 Norfolk State with 7:40 left in the first half. Spartans hitting 50% from the floor, Hawks 35%. Andino, Rivera, Elliott, Copeland, and Martland are out there. Short has it right wing, guarded closely by Martin, well outside the perimeter. He's being pressured near midcourt now as he gives up to the right side and to Sean Taylor. Taylor through the paint, up and in, and one. Thomas Rivera hit him on the wrist. It was a quick little slap, but it didn't sneak by the watchful eyes of Jose Carrion. First foul on Rivera, sixth on the Hawks, and Taylor has an and one coming. It's up and no good. Rebound pulled in by Wade, and then a jump ball as Elliott got his hands on it near the free throw line. But the possession arrow keeps it with the visiting Spartans.
How about that? The number one team in the free throw shooting team in the country has missed three in a row.
They are 3 for 8 this evening shooting free throws.
Wow.
Here's Derek Opek replacing Bakari Copeland as they wipe up the floor near where the bodies went flying at that free throw line. Hawks riding a four-game win streak. They haven't won five in a row in almost two decades. Butler mishandled the inbounds pass, but Norfolk State keeps possession. It's Short now on the left-hand side, working against Peck. Short gets a screen, goes to the top of the arc against Andino. Jump stops in the key, forced it up from the elbow, missed it. Rebound, Devin Martin. Good box out as he forced Taylor backwards. Here's Martin on the right wing. Under 7 minutes to play in the first half. A bounce pass into the right corner where Elliott fakes, guns a pass to the left side. Andino forced a three and missed it short. Norfolk State holds the Hawks to a one and done.
It's our sixth three in a row we just missed.
Peck and company force a turnover in the forecourt as Taylor taps his chest and says, that was my bad, mishandling the ball.
25-21. Wild up and down there.
That's right. The Hawks haven't hit a basket since the 12:34 mark. There's 6:34 left in a half. 6 full minutes. Martin in the right corner. He wants a three, and he got it. 25-24. A little off balance, kind of fading away, but Devin with good touch. Leading scorer for the Hawks, 17 a night. Put in the big bucket. Cuts the lead to just 25-24 now, Norfolk State. Spartans have the ball left wing. Wade passes up top to Short. Bounces it to the right side, and Taylor, who's had stone hands lately. He guns it into the high post. Wade gives it right back to him. Here's a three from Taylor. Right side, air ball. Elliott squares away the basketball and lets it go out of bounds untouched.
That was a force. That was a good defense by the Hawks. You have to give them credit. They forced their players further out from the three-point line. The ball hadn't got inside to Butler. The Hawks playing good D.
UMES won by 18 points in Norfolk a year ago, thanks to a big-time shooting exposition in the second half last year. That game was just a one-point affair at halftime. Here's Elliott underneath, drawing a foul on the way up. Got a good pass from Rivera, and Elliott goes back to the stripe. Sixth foul on Norfolk State. It goes on Jordan Butler. He and Alex Long both have 2 fouls. And so Elliott goes to the stripe. We'll see if that maybe forces Norfolk State to go with a slightly smaller lineup. Long and Butler are their 2 best big men. They do have an additional player who is even bigger, as Elliott can't hit the free throw. Moses, let me make sure I pronounce this right, Toriola. Toriola, Moses Toriola, a freshman from Nigeria, is 6'10", 230, and he'll check in now for Jordan Butler. I imagine Toriola and Elliott will have some battles in the post here. Dominique missed them both. Short boxes him out. 25-24 Norfolk State as Caldwell comes to the scores table for UMES. Skip pass over the defense to the left corner to Charles Oliver, who's a great shooter. Oliver drives on Elliott, bounces underneath, and he threw it away. I think... was there a foul called?
No, I think Peck may have hit the ball when it was out of bounds.
Okay. I was going to say, I thought it was just cleanly dribbling along the baseline. Andino leaves the floor, Caldwell in. 15 to shoot for the Spartans, who inbound under the basket. On the left side, Peck jumps straight up in the air, deflects it, and pulls it straight down. Great defense. Here's Rivera into the forecourt. Thomas Rivera finds Devin Martin. Devin drives into the left corner, stops, pops, and it does not fall from 18. Norfolk State with the ball and a one-point lead. Wade explodes toward the hoop, sidesteps the defense and slips it over the front of the rim. He gets his teammates up and dancing on the bench, waving their towels. 27-24. Martin to tie the game for 3, left side. Yes, he did. 27-27. Devin Martin with a great start for the Hawks.
Back-to-back threes for the Hawks. That'll get you back in the game every time.
Good balance on the offensive end. Martin leads the way with 6 points in 11 minutes. Tied at 27. Oliver at the point with 4:38 to go in the first half. Short at the top of the arc, passes right wing to Wade. He'll go into the corner. Fake from 3 from Oliver, then he'll raise. It clanks off the back of the orange. Long rebound into the corner off a deflection. Norfolk State controls. Robinson back to the top. Short fakes and drives, and he's held by Caldwell. Dante put his hands on it.
Yep.
That's the 7th on the Hawks, and it puts them in the bonus.
They're going to call that way outside. They've been doing it all year. Keep your hands off the guy 30 feet from the basket.
First personal on Caldwell. Elliott leaves the floor. Peck, Caldwell, Randall, Martin, and Rivera are out there as Short's free throw is up and short.
Oh.
Man, Norfolk State uncharacteristic tonight from the line. Again, they are the best free throw shooting team in the country. Caldwell in the left corner finds Martin, who steps into another left wing three. No, Peck with a putback dunk. Errico Peck blows the roof off the Hike Center. 29-27 UMES.
That's what he does best. comes from way outside to slam that baby home off the rebound.
Yeah, I would imagine that if you're the visiting coaching staff, you've got Peck's number circled every rebound opportunity. Robinson at the free throw line, kicks toward the corner. Toriola fakes, picks up his dribble after one bounce, and with 5 seconds on the shot clock, he was fouled, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Oh, that's Peck or Randall, one of the two.
We'll see. It's on Jericho Peck. Well, we've got a timeout on the floor. 3:40 left in our first half as Peck picks up his second. And UMES has a 29-27 lead. Hang in there. We'll be back in a moment. This is the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Bobby, you're here again.
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of 7 entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of 7 sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
The Hawks are coming home.
Just hold on, going home.
It's UMES Homecoming 2K16. The Hawks have big plans starting Valentine's Day with a gospel explosion. Monday the 15th, it's a Shore Overload Bonfire. The Homecoming concert is Thursday the 18th. On Friday the 19th, it's the UMES Hall of Fame induction ceremony. Then Saturday, the Hawks face South Carolina State at the Heights. Get tickets and details at umestickets.com.
Get UMES Hawks basketball anywhere. Listen on your phone with the TuneIn app. Search SFM Sports Channel 2.
Maryland Eastern Shore with a 29-27 lead. This game has been hotly contested in the first half. We've had 10 lead changes and 5 ties already. Back and forth, the game has been played in a tight margin. Largest lead for Norfolk State, 4 points. Largest lead for the Hawks was 3 points. Right now, it's a 2-point UMES edge. On the floor, Caldwell, Martin, Randall, Peck, and Mark Seelin. Got an official standing in my way. Toriola at the line, a 1-1. And he bricked it long. Offensive board, put back, no. Bungay with the rebound, and he couldn't connect. This is unbelievable. Norfolk State's at 3 of 10 from the free throw line in the first half. Dante Caldwell in the forecourt, hands to Seelin, who goes to his left. Didn't mean to cut you off there, partner.
No, I was thinking that's been 6 in a row then. That's really unfair.
Caldwell, right corner, 3, you bet. Dante Caldwell starting to get in rhythm. He's got 8 points in the first half, and Maryland Eastern Shore has a 5-point edge over Norfolk State. Jeff Short up top, fakes a pass to the right, wants Caldwell to himself, raises for 3, hand in his face, hardly hit the net on the way down as Short does the dab on his way back up the floor.
Man. He can shoot it without question.
32-30, Jeff Short has already hit 4 first half three-pointers. He's got 12 points to lead all scorers. Caldwell's got the team high 8. Seelin, top of the arc, goes to his left. Martin drives on an opening, pulls up left baseline and hits. 15-foot jumper, nicely done.
Nice stop and pop on the left baseline by Martin.
8 points for Devin Martin. He's hit 2 of 8. Robinson between the rings, goes to his right. Gets the pass right back from Oliver. Dribbling with his right hand, waist high, 16 to shoot. Robinson looking around to the post, passes to Short, outside the arc, right side. Peck is right in his grill, and Derrico put his hands on him. That's Derrico Peck's 3rd personal foul. And without Derrico Peck, I would imagine now for the rest of the first half, the Hawks have to figure it out.
And then he has to be in there because he instills some enthusiasm. Got to come off the bench and get that. You cannot put your hands on him above that 3-point line. It's going to be called.
Hawks lead it 34-30 as Randall and Peck both check back out. Bakari Copeland, Dominique Elliott enter the game. 1-1 for Jeff Short. Again, Short 83% from the line on the season. Tonight, 4 of 5 from deep, 0 of 1 from the stripe, and he missed another one. This is unbelievable. Seelin, between the circles, looking right side, hands the ball to Devin Martin. They've hit 3 of 11 free throws.
And that's what allowed the Hawks to get this lead.
34-30, UMES on their home floor with under 2 to play in the first half. Copeland gets the bounce pass up top, find Martin open, left corner, 3 ball. He hit another! Devin Martin blowing kisses to the crowd, 37-30.
He's shooting it now. He's feeling it.
Robinson through the key. Up and no good with the right hand. Elliott had the rebound slapped away from him, but it went right to Mark Seeland, who slows the tempo. UMES in their biggest game of the season. I think you could make that argument. 37-30. They lead at home. Final 120 of the first half. It's been a good start. Long way to go. Seeland looks to Martin, left corner. Devin wants Dominique Elliott to get toward the post. Devin dribbling around the perimeter. Step back, fadeaway three. Couldn't hit it. Rebound underneath. Was tipped twice. And I think Toriola hit Dante Caldwell.
He might have been fouled from underneath. I'm not sure.
It is on Toriola.
Right.
Caldwell will shoot 1-1.
The Hawks rebounders are getting open, going to the basket from a long distance away. They're just filling that gap and getting to the basketball like Peck and now Caldwell.
So a little bit of a stall on the floor. Not sure exactly what needed to be worked out. Everybody just sort of talking to each other. But we've got 1-1. Everybody picks up their matchups. Dante Caldwell at the stripe for UMES. It's up and good. This is exactly what you want to see out of Dante Caldwell.
Yes.
He's getting an opportunity, and he's taking full advantage of it. Caldwell, a 77% free throw shooter, had 25 points 2 weeks ago at Coppin State in a big overtime win in that one. Caldwell hit them both. 39-30, Maryland Eastern Shore. And wisely, Coach Collins pulls his senior leader, Devin Martin, off the floor and puts Mark Blackman in. Blackman really known for his defensive aggressiveness. Here we go.
Last minute of the first half.
Wade on the left wing, passes up top to Robinson, who gets a screen right. He goes back up top to Taylor, who shoots a three from dead on and pops it in. 39-33.
Set play that time. Taylor runs right to the eye.
Timeout, Maryland Eastern Shore. Yeah, you're right. That was well designed and well executed. So the first timeout burn for the Hawks. They won't lose one at the intermission. First timeout called for by either team here this evening. Hope you'll stick around for the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. We'll give you a comprehensive look at the first half numbers. And get ready for the second half. And what is, I think you could really make the argument, Dave, probably the biggest game of the season for these two teams. Because right now it's about momentum. For Norfolk State, they've won 5 of 6. And even though the Hawks are only 5-4 in conference, they know this is a momentum game for both sides.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You don't have to make any, this is the most important. It's kind of jumpstart you into the final 2 or 3 weeks of the MEAC season. And this jumps you to next weekend when the Hawks are at Delaware State and at Howard, which could be, if we play well,
you'd certainly like to think we could at least pick up one of those. 39-33, final 40 seconds of the first half. Hawks have the ball shooting to the basket off to our right. Martin has it left wing, gives up top to Seeland. Copeland, Elliott, and Caldwell also out there. 12 to shoot, 30 seconds to play. Seeland on an ISO, down the middle, passes out to Caldwell right wing, who goes to the elbow, pulls up, missed it right. Rebound toward the baseline, pulled in by Norfolk State. Robinson takes it across the midcourt stripe, waiting for a last second shot. Seeland bothering him out near the M logo at midcourt. Robinson protecting the ball, dribbling to the right-hand side of the floor with 10 seconds to play. Robinson from dead on, he's got cushion, shoots an open three, missed it short, put back is fouled. Oh, man. Taylor had great positioning as he slipped underneath, tried to dunk it home. Thankfully, it didn't go down. Caldwell picks up his second personal, team 10th, but two free throws coming anyways from Taylor with 4.4 seconds left on our first half clock.
And there's time to get a shot off here. We better be ready to
sure
rebound this and go because they haven't made any.
Norfolk State shooting 2. They've hit 3 of 11 in the first half, 27%. and they missed another one.
3-12. Holy, the best shooting free throw team in the country now.
And it's not an exaggeration. They are the best team in Division I basketball. Up and good. Timeout.
Wow.
Spartans, 39-34. 4 of 13 free throws in the first half.
That's the difference in the first half score.
It's absolutely the difference.
If they made their normal average, they'd be up a couple of buckets.
So just 4.4 seconds left. I think Norfolk State may have done the Hawks a favor there by giving UMES a chance to draw up a play here.
Yeah.
5-point edge for the Hawks. Norfolk State burns their first timeout, and they come back out defensively.
A little full-court pressure here by Norfolk. They got a big guy all the way back.
Robinson, Wade, Taylor, Short, and Toriola for Norfolk State. Copeland, Martin, Caldwell, Seelan, and Elliott for the Hawks. Bakari to inbound. He gets it to Elliott near midcourt. Elliott is dribbling from half court to the three-point line. He hoists, and he can't not brick it home. I don't think that's exactly what they wanted, but if you're Norfolk State, that's who you wanted to have the basketball. So we've reached halftime with the host UMES Hawks leading 39-34. In a wild first half, back and forth. We've seen some really nice shots. We've seen some real head scratchers.
Yeah, our head scratcher is, how in the world does Norfolk State miss all those free throws and allow the Hawks this 5-1 lead?
All right, we'll take a timeout. When we come back, we'll give you the halftime report and take a look at the first half numbers. It's Maryland Eastern Shore by 5 at the break, 39-34. This is the Hawks Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Yesterday, I was embarrassed to have guests use my bathroom. Today, I can't wait to show it off. What a difference a day makes. It started with a simple phone call to Quick Bath Remodel Center. They connected us to a free in-home design consultation. We chose the style and color we wanted and then turned our old mildewy shower and tub into a luxurious shower we love. The remodel was quick, done in just one day. Here's the best part. Quick Bath Remodel Center referred us to factory-trained installers who handled everything for us. They custom-made our new walk-in shower to fit our existing bathroom space. Our home is not only more beautiful, it's more valuable, too. Imagine getting a beautiful new bathroom you'll love in just one day. We did it, and so can you, when you call Quick Bath Remodel Center today.
Call 800-870-3137. That's 800-870-3137. 800-870-3137. Call today, 800-870-3137.
The Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. 13 institutions all striving as one to excel in the classroom and on the field. A premier Division I conference with 16 sponsored sports showcasing the talents and strengths of our student athletes through hard work and perseverance. The Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, educating student athletes for the game of life.
Driving can be frustrating, but aggressive driving will get you nowhere. Speeding or ignoring traffic signals is dangerous and unlawful, resulting in tickets, fines, and points. You can't control traffic, but you can control your driving. So plan an alternate route and allow plenty of time to reach your destination. Drive courteously, because like aggressive driving, courtesy is contagious. And wear your seatbelt. It's the law in Maryland and your best defense against an aggressive driver. This message brought to you by the Maryland Department of Transportation and this station.
This is UMES Basketball on the Hawks Sports Network, powered by sfmsports.net. The all-access halftime show starts now.
Maryland Eastern Shore leads 39-34 at halftime. From the Heights Center, Brendan Gulick and Dave Bird with you on the Buffalo Wild Wings All-Access Halftime Show. Norfolk State, it's probably safe to say, that even though North Carolina Central has been the best team in the conference the last 3 years, maybe it's Norfolk State that's the measuring stick, because they are the only school in the MEAC that has been to four consecutive postseason tournaments. They've continued to play well this year, 7-2 in conference play. They've already played Hampton, and they lost to Hampton. That game happened just last weekend, but they have already beaten South Carolina State. That's a big win for them, because South Carolina State's just half a game ahead of them in the standings. The only other MEAC loss they suffered was to Bethune-Cookman back in mid-January. They lost to Bethune-Cookman at home, 72-70. Bethune-Cookman is right on their tail. So I would argue the top five teams in the conference right now really bunched together. And to be totally honest with you, it's anybody's ballgame.
Yeah, you're 100% correct. And that's the most important reason we need to win tonight here at the High Center. Because it looked like if you go away, it's going to be a tough W anywhere within the top five of the MEAC conference. And looking 3 weeks down the road, it's hard to tell who you would like to be matched up.
Yeah, I mean, it's way too early.
Four
or
five and all that. But they're starting to look at that, because especially after tonight's
basketball. Well, sure. After tonight's game, you've got six games left. But still, I would argue that given the parity in the conference, there's so much that can change in those six games because of the tiebreakers that are going to come into effect. You can't get too worried about that yet. But the idea that if the Hawks can win tonight, then they will win the only game against Norfolk. They'll win the only game against Hampton. They'll win the only game they play against Bethune-Cookman. And they've lost once to South Carolina State, with a second crack at them here at home in a couple weeks. If you could find a way to go 4-1 against those four teams in five games, I mean, that's really all you can ask for from a momentum perspective. Yeah, and I realize there's a lot of game to go, but that's the thought process.
I agree with you 100%. The main, it's still balls. I go back, if we hold service here at home and win, then it is a big win for the Hawks, especially looking next weekend when there's a possibility of a couple wins on short trips away from the Heights Center.
Maryland Eastern Shore has played a brutal schedule this season, so a five-point lead at halftime over a conference foe, no matter who it is, doesn't feel like much compared to playing Michigan State, Maryland, Georgetown, and Pittsburgh all on the road. That's the idea.
I agree with that. I'm going to ask you a question. What do you've seen? We've seen Hampton play. We've seen this group play. I mean, I don't think there's a whole lot of difference, but I think Hampton has a little more size. And these two, Hampton and Norfolk State, are pretty close.
I think they're very much on equal footing.
Right.
I like what Quentin Chivas brings to Hampton's team. He's a versatile player who can also shoot from the outside, but he's very physical in the paint, and when he plays, I know he's missed a couple games, but when he's out there, he makes Hampton a very competitive team. And to be totally honest with you, I'm not convinced that Hampton would lose that game against the Hawks every time, because I think Hampton shot the ball pretty poorly here on Saturday. And if they have a good shooting day, I think they can win that game. But I would rather have the guards that Norfolk State has.
Right. I would take the guards that Norfolk State has. But Hampton has the better inside people, I think, and Justin Busbaxter, the big guy in the middle, was an animal the other night. We won the basketball game because our guards outplayed their guards. They just did not shoot the ball very well.
We'll take a quick timeout. When we come back, we'll give you the first half numbers. It's Maryland Eastern Shore 39, Norfolk State 34. You're listening to the Hawks Sports Network tonight on sfmsports.net.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people.
The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
Do you need a break, a getaway? Plan a visit to Hyatt Place Dewey Beach in Delaware. Lay back, relax with your toes in the sand, and unwind to the sounds of the ocean. Please your palate with a delicious meal at Cape Hasa Restaurant on the bay while taking in the sights of a beautiful sunset. It's time to get away and make that getaway to the Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. Call 302-864-9100 or visit HyattPlaceDeweyBeach.com. Make a lifetime of memories in your own backyard at Hyatt Place Dewey Beach. That's Hyatt Place Dewey Beach on Facebook and Instagram.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
The UMES Hawks All Access Halftime Show continues on SFMSports.net.
As we continue on the halftime show this evening, it's Maryland Eastern Shore 39 and Norfolk State 34. Let's give you the first half numbers first for the visiting Spartans. Leading scorer is Jeff Short, 12 points on 4 of 7 shooting. All four have been three-point shots. He played 18 minutes in the first half and had one rebound. 9 points for Deshaun Taylor, 2 of 6 shooting. He hit 4 of 7 free throws. The rest of the team missed all 6 free throws. 6 points for Jordan Butler. He hit all 3 shots, also pulled in 3 rebounds. Alex Long had 2 fouls fairly early in the first half. Yeah. Didn't play a lot, just 4 minutes. He had 2 points, a rebound, and 1 assist. Zanai Robinson, 3 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists. He's been under control pretty much the whole game. And 2 points for Jonathan Wade. Norfolk State, 6 assists, 4 turnovers. They shot 46%, including 6 of 10 threes. But again, just 4 of 13 free throws for the number one free throw shooting team in the country. As a team, they shoot 78% from the line, but just 31% in the first half. For Maryland Eastern Shore, 11 points for Devin Martin is a team high, 4 of 10. He hit 3 of 6 threes. Devin also had 1 rebound and 1 block shot. Dante Caldwell came off the bench with 10 big points. He's hit all 4 free throws, 2 three-pointers in a 2 of 4 shooting effort in the first half. 5 points for Shane Randall, all of them early in the game, including a 3. Dominique Elliott had just 3 points in the first half, 7 rebounds, 3 assists for Elliott. He also had 1 block shot. Makari Copeland, in 11 minutes, had 2 points and 2 rebounds. Thomas Rivera, 3 points, 4 dimes, 1 turnover in the first half. Derek Opek came off the bench, played 9 minutes, had just 2 points, 5 rebounds, a block and 2 steals. Mark Seeland, 7 minutes off the bench, had an assist. Ryan Andino, 3 points in 6 minutes. The Hawks had 10 assists and 4 turnovers with 4 block shots. UMES plus 5 on the glass. They hit 43% from the floor, 47% from deep. The Hawks hit 8 of 17 three-pointers in the first half. They are also shooting well, and 7 of 10 from the free throw line. So, you know, if you look at the numbers all in all, Maryland Eastern Shore is doing their job because they're hitting from the outside, but they've got to do a better job of defending Jeff Short, recognizing he's probably going to get his, but you've still got to contest every look he puts up.
And another amazing stat is, in a game that was kind of hectic at times and kind of wild at times and no scoring for, you know, 5 or 6 minute droughts because neither team shot the ball very well, very few turnovers in the half, only 4 for each team. So I think things might get in a flow the second half, and we'll see some scoring from both sides.
Hawks have won 4 in a row. and have won six in a row here on their home floor, only losing once all season. That was back the fourth game of the season. It was the home opener against Fairfield. But since then, six consecutive wins. UMES has been very difficult here at home, and even though they opened the season with 17 of their first 22 games on the road, it's been nice to have some home games here of late, where hopefully this team is starting to feel like they're putting things together. Thomas Rivera said it best to me the other day when I asked him about the chemistry. He said, you know what? Thought about it for a second, and he goes, we just want to win. And everybody realizes that that's all we're trying to do. We're just trying to win basketball games. We don't really care who scores. We don't really care who touches the ball. We just want to win. Yeah. We were sick of losing early in the year, and as a team, we're starting to gel. And I think that's the attitude that you're going to need going down the stretch of the regular season.
You're 100% correct, and that's the attitude Bobby Collins has instilled in this group and has been telling them that, and they have bought into that a mess of times, and now in this streak going, if they can win again tonight, then they're really going to be a buy-in mode.
Well, if Maryland Eastern Shore can win tonight, it would be their fifth straight win for the first time in about two decades. And you don't want to look too far ahead in the schedule, because we just saw the women's side, and Maryland Eastern Shore women tonight lost to a team that entered 1-19. It truly is any team on any given night. We'll step aside, and when we come back, it's the second half between UMES and Norfolk State from the Heights Center in Princess Anne here on the Hawks Sports Network.
Bobby, you here again?
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Hey fans, have you heard that UMES is trying to raise $48,000 in just 48 hours? You heard me right, 48 grand in 48 hours for UMES, here to support your athletic and academic programs. So please be prepared to make a difference this homecoming, February 19th through February 21st.
Each week, go inside the athletics program at the University of Maryland Eastern Shore with Hawks Talk.
I'm Brendan Gulick, radio voice of the Hawks, and we're joined today by head coach Bobby Collins.
Here from UMES coaches.
The one thing that we did, we played hard.
Student athletes.
Being a student athlete, obviously student is first.
We're happy to do it in front of what is a really nice crowd here on Wednesday night at Buffalo Wild Wings on Route 13 in Salisbury. We'll be here from 7 to 8.
It's Hawks Talk from SFMSports.net on Fox Sports 960.
Hey, this is Thomas Rivera, junior point guard. Thanks for listening to Maryland Eastern Shore Basketball. This is the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Buckle in. It's the second half between UMES and Norfolk State tonight, with the Hawks on top by 5 points. Dave, what's your big key to the second half if the Hawks want to walk out of here with their fifth straight win?
I think defensively is the key. We got to contain Norfolk State at the perimeter three-point line. Do not let them get off and knock down, you know, two or three shots in a row.
Only player for either team in foul trouble, Derek Opek. He's got three. No one else has more than two. It'll be Hawks ball to start the half. They'll go from right to left with Copeland, Rivera, Martin, Randall, and Elliott out there to get things going. Butler, Long, Robinson, Short, and Taylor are out there for Norfolk State. Both teams with their starting lineup. Here we go. Rivera between the rings, looking to his right. He's got Martin in the post. Devin pops back out and receives a bounce pass out the perimeter. Devin tried to pull up, then pass left corner for a Copeland three. It was too long out of his hand. Randall couldn't corral the rebound. Instead, he tipped it out of bounds back to Norfolk State.
Great position by Randall. Just couldn't bring it down. Wide open three-pointer from the left baseline by Copeland.
Hawks lead it 39-34, opening minute of the second half. Norfolk State out of the halftime locker room after shooting 4 of 13 from the free throw line in that opening frame. Short on the left wing. He is a talent. Short dribbles to the top of the arc, gives to Long, who throws underneath, and Taylor is there for a, I should say, Butler is there for a two-hand dunk. 39-36.
That was a pretty easy basket that time for the first possession down. Yeah.
Elliott in the post goes to work. Couple fakes, banks it home. Nice job on the right hand. Elliott with three defenders working around him.
Now, I think you're going to see a lot more than 3 points this half from Dominique.
Reigning conference player of the week with three double-doubles his last five nights. 41-36. Short on the left wing, draws a double. Gives up top to Butler, who wants to drive on Elliott. Kicks to a Robinson open three right corner. And he puts it in. Robinson runs back up the floor, holding three fingers in the air to make it a 41-39 contest.
I don't know if I would do that if I'm losing. You know what I mean?
He's done it just about every time he's come up the floor. Robinson's got 6 points, a couple threes tonight. Rivera in the key, bounces to Elliott underneath. Two-hand flush. 43-39. Minute and a half gone, second half.
I think we're going to see a little more scoring this second half.
Wouldn't bother me.
Me either.
Robinson dribbling to the midcourt stripe, partially with his back to the basket. Goes to the right side, back to the top of the arc now, and Butler. Short running the baseline without the basketball. Wants it, though. Butler still holding it. Now he'll hand to Short, who came all the way to the top of the arc. Short bounces to Robinson on the left wing, seven to shoot. Gave it underneath. Long up and under, and one. Randall came from behind. It was a sloppy attempt from Randall to try to block the shot. He never really had a good look at it. Shane picks up his first foul, and he'll give Long a chance to tie the game.
He'd been better off just letting him go. You know what I mean?
Check that. It would make it a one-point game. It's now 43-41. I agree with you. He never really should have made that effort. Didn't have a good chance to put it up. So, 1:59 has ticked by, and here's Long at the stripe. Takes an extra breath from the line, puts it up and in. 43-42 UMES. Norfolk State has cut that five-point deficit to one pretty quickly. Rivera runs the point. Hawks without Ahmad Frost tonight after an injured left knee last week. Martin for three, just left of center, and he started running backwards up the floor before the ball even went down. 46-42. Devin knew it right away. Crowd's a little quiet at the moment. Hawks by four. Robinson, top of the arc, goes to his right. Taylor back to Robinson, who fakes left, drives left. Goes through the paint, bounced it to nobody. Out of bounds on the sideline. Maybe he thought Long was there back door, but nobody touched it as Taylor and Long talked to each other coming up the floor.
First turnover of the second half, fifth of the game for Norfolk.
46-42 Hawks, 17-18 left second half. Rivera on the left side of the floor, halfway between the three-point line and the midcourt line. 15 on the shot clock, Thomas dribbling around and a whistle away from the ball. Goes on Shane Randall, he made an illegal screen. Randall picks up his second foul in 2 minutes. Second foul on the Hawks here in the second half. And again, you don't want to give Norfolk State chances to shoot free throws. I know what they've done tonight. I'm not banking on that. They're the number one free throw shooting team in the country for a reason.
We're going to make them later.
Robinson, between the circles, going to his right. Looking around, crosses up Copeland a few times. Gives to Butler high in the post. Butler finds on the left wing Taylor, who drew a foul. No shot. That one goes on Elliott. Elliott picks up his first personal. Team third, and we've played 3 minutes and 8 seconds in the second half. UMES is putting unnecessary pressure on themselves here early in the second half. At a five-point lead at halftime, it's a four-point edge at the moment. But it kind of feels like momentum Norfolk as we've got a foul on Norfolk State immediately on the inbound. That one goes on Robinson. Zanai Robinson pushed off as he tried to free up. Wow. That was sort of a ticky-tack call, if I'm being real.
That's right.
First foul on Robinson, first of the half on the Spartans. They throw it up top. Copeland gets lucky. Martin is there. To Rivera, right corner, high arcing, two-pointer, no. High rebound comes down to Taylor. Here's Short running up the floor, and he'll finish with a right-hand layup. Timeout called for by Norfolk State, I believe. Okay, maybe not. I guess head coach Robert Jones was putting his hands together, touching his fingertips
for a defensive call
to tell him how we want to match up defensively if you're Norfolk State. He's not
that.
Calling a timeout.
He needs to give it a little more clearer.
So a substitution. Randall leaves the floor. Ryan Andino's back out there. 46-44. UMES leads by two. 16-24 left second half. Rivera dribbles on the right wing as Elliott tries to post up. Thomas can't get him the ball, so he passes to Copeland. Now works around the perimeter left side. On the baseline, Devin Martin back to the basket. Spins, fakes, puts it up, fades away. No. Copeland tries to rip down the rebound, but Long has the longer arms and pulls it in.
Big-time advantage, though, for Martin against Robertson with his size.
Here's Robinson, top of the arc, dribbling through a double team. Passes to Butler, who fakes from the free throw line and travels. No, he gets called for a foul. Oh, come on.
Well, he walked too.
Man alive.
Timeout on the floor.
I think it's on Elliott. Yep. It goes on Dominique, his second, team fourth. We've only played 4 minutes of the second half. Hawks by two, but it feels like the bottom's starting to fall out against Norfolk State. Back in a moment. This is the Hawks Sports Network on SFMSports.net.
Gary Stockbridge, Delmarva Power Region President on investing in communities.
Over the next 5 years, we're investing $1.7 billion in our electric systems. Advanced technology is helping us be more responsive while letting you take control of your energy use. And we're trimming trees along more than 1,600 miles of power lines to help prevent outages and ensure reliability. This is our commitment to you. Our work continues.
Delmarva Power, online at delmarva.com.
The Hawks are coming home.
Just hold on, going home.
It's UMES Homecoming 2K16. The Hawks have big plans starting Valentine's Day with a gospel explosion. Monday the 15th, it's the Shore Overload Bonfire. The Homecoming concert is Thursday the 18th. On Friday the 19th, it's the UMES Hall of Fame induction ceremony. Then Saturday, the Hawks face South Carolina State at the Heights. Get tickets and details at umestickets.com.
We now pause 10 seconds for station identification. This is UMES Basketball on the Hawks Sports Network from sfmsports.net.
Delmarva Power invites you to try my account. It's our free online tool that offers tips on how to save energy and money on your electric bill. Find out how much you can save by upgrading to energy-efficient appliances, adding insulation or storm windows. You can even take a home energy audit with my account. It's fast, convenient, and easy to use. Just visit Delmarva.com and click on My Account. Delmarva Power, your life, plugged in. Hawks defending the inbound play, but not well enough as Taylor takes it to the middle of the paint, puts in the layup to tie the game at 46. We're at the 15-44 mark of the second half, and the five-point lead the Hawks had at the intermission has evaporated. Andino puts a three in from way outside the arc right wing. Thomas Rivera picks up his seventh assist of the night, and the Hawks take a three-point lead back. Quickly dwindled to one as Jeff Short goes up the floor. And from the right side, banks one in while falling over from 15 feet.
Yeah, well, it was Sam Jonas, that's a little old style, but you probably don't know that. But it's an excellent bank shot off the ground.
Andino a three left corner, too long. Butler rips down the rebound for Norfolk State. Here they come running. Short, stops, pops, three ball right side, no. Popped away, it was halfway down.
Wow, that looked good out of Short's hands. We got a break.
49-48, UMES. Under 15 to play. Thomas Rivera having a really solid game running the point today. His career-high 8 assists earlier this year. Copeland on the baseline, pumped once, had it blocked from behind on the second attempt. Loose ball picked up by the Spartans in the backcourt. Robinson across the timeline goes to the right. Passes back to Short. Left elbow, no-look pass underneath, and it turns into a dunk for Jordan Butler. 50-49, Norfolk State. They have completely erased the halftime deficit, and the Hawks trail by one. In the right corner, Andino goes back to Rivera. Thomas from the keyhole passes left baseline. Here's Copeland on his way up, and it's an offensive foul. That was the right call.
Yeah. Copeland trying to do too much. Wide open on the boat. left-hand baseline, about 18 feet. He didn't take that shot, and instead he run over a guy in the middle of the lane.
That's the fifth foul on the Hawks in the opening 5:36 of this first half. Here's Mark Seelan back in the game for Thomas Rivera. Again, Rivera, 13 minutes. He's only got 3 points, but he's really dished out the ball well. 7 assists.
I mean, he's playing about the same amount of minutes that he did before, but this time we do not have Frost.
Seelan is out there instead. Frost with a knee injury. There's Butler on the left wing giving it up. Now Taylor outside the arc, drives in the middle of the paint, bounces right corner. Long, a bounce, a high arcing shot, never looked good out of his hand. Missed it, long left. Rebound, Devin Martin. Here comes Martin all the way up the floor, gives up to Copeland last second, who forced his way into the lane, and he was fouled on the floor before he made his way to the hoop. We'll see who it's hit on. There were several players there. It'll be a baseline inbound as Dante Caldwell comes back in. Goes on Alex Long. That's his third personal for Norfolk. Spartans lead by one at the moment. 13:46 left on the clock as Martin exits for the time being with Caldwell entering the game.
If we get the same amount of points from Caldwell as the first half, then we're going to be good to go.
Dante had 10 off the bench. Freshman from L.A. has had a couple 20-point games in his career. Only the third time tonight, though, that he's gone into double digits. Seelan to the right side and Elliott. Dom holding outside the arc, up top to Copeland. Bakari's played very well of late. Makes a move toward the right elbow, hard to the rim, and he's fouled. This time in the act of shooting, I think it's on Long again. Sure is. He just picked up his fourth. The freshman with four fouls and still 13 and a half minutes left. And he's going to have to sit.
Norfolk probably going to go small.
So Charles Oliver will come back in. Copeland at the line. Puts the first free throw up, and he missed it to the right. No good. He's got one more chance to tie the game. Here's Oliver back on the floor. Long takes a seat. Copeland on the day. 2 of 3 from the line now. He's got just 2 points.
Norfolk goes extremely small with Butler as the biggest guy at 6'6".
Copeland split the pair. 50-50. 13 and a half minutes left in a really good game here in the MEAC. Robinson up top working against Seelan man-to-man. Passes left side now. Taylor holding the ball. Works on Andino. Fakes once. Bounces around him. Butler spins around Elliott. Stops. And I think he traveled. He sure did. I'm not sure Norfolk State necessarily agrees with the call, as Robert Jones and his assistants are all shaking their head. But nobody's really up in arms about it.
No, and you called it early.
Crowd has been a little quiet here in the second half. Maybe a big bucket here will get them back into it. Seelan hands to Caldwell, and now Andino joins the weave. Back to Seelan up top. He goes to the left. Under 13 minutes to play in the ballgame. Seelan has it up top. Mark, not a big deep ball threat, but he can shoot it. Goes to the right, into the corner, fade away to, no. Rebound tipped up into the air. Robinson comes down with it. The short guard has been all over the place tonight. 3 points, 4 rebounds, 4 assists, and he's run the offense well. He drives and feeds here to Butler. Kick to short, left corner, 3 short. Here's Seelan in transition, 3-on-1. Finds Caldwell. Dante, Euro steps through the lane, and the reverse layup attempt didn't go. But Caldwell has free throws coming. That was sweet.
I thought it was almost in. He could have used his left hand. That baby would have went in on the left side. The Hawks look good when they're pushing the ball to the floor. They get a good shot at it, a good look at it.
They are better in transition than they are in the half-court offense.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
You're right.
I was putting it a little nicer way.
Okay.
That's it.
First foul on Charles Oliver. Dante Caldwell's free throw's good. That's the fourth foul on Norfolk State here in the second half. Zanai Robinson leaves the floor, and that brings Devontae Banner, the sophomore, off the bench. Caldwell has one more coming, this to try to make it a 2-point lead. The freshman put it up and put it in. 52-50 as Martin and Peck return for Copeland and Andino. Maybe something big from Rico Peck will get this crowd into it.
And fired up, that's right.
That is in his DNA. Graduate student who finished up his undergraduate degree at Northeastern at the age of 20. And Short goes right into a double team and is forced to burn a timeout. There's 12:18 left in the second half. This will become a media timeout, and the Hawks have a 52-50 lead. Back in a moment, Maryland Eastern Shore by two here on the Hawks Sports Network.
Ah, please, God, give me a sign.
What do you need, son?
God?
No, I'm your Signs by Tomorrow customer representative, but I can help you.
When you need to put your business in the best possible light, Signs by Tomorrow can get the job done and done right away. From lighted signs to vehicle graphics, the new Easton location is now open at Dover Road and Route 50. Call 410-770-9825. At Signs by Tomorrow, we don't just provide signs, we provide peace of mind.
The Courtyard by Marriott on Route 13 in Salisbury offers comfortable rooms and meeting spaces, as well as always superior customer service in a great location near the mall. Call 410-742-4405 and ask for details about their special UMES athletics rate. The Courtyard by Marriott in Salisbury, an official hotel of UMES Athletics and a proud sponsor of Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Hawks Basketball from SFMSports.net.
Hawks are working on one of their best games of the year in terms of protecting the ball. Just six turnovers in the first 28 minutes of this game. We've got just over 12 minutes left in the second half, and Maryland Eastern Shore has a 52-50 lead over one of the best teams in the MEAC over the last decade, the Norfolk State Spartans. In fact, it might even be longer than that. Martin has a team-high 14. Caldwell has 12 off the bench. Three Spartans in double figures, led by Jeff Shorts, game-high 16. UMES in the second half at 4 of 10. Spartans 7 of 10. And it make it 7 of 11 as Peck goes up and contests the layup. And on a ball that goes out of bounds, I guess Taylor was not the last to touch it. Wow, I thought Derek Peck was going to come away with that ball clean.
Taylor stuck his hand there and knocked it out, knocked it into Peck's hand, and then out of bounds. Underneath our, Norfolk State underneath their own basket in a box.
They'll lob it out toward the three-point line. Short has it on the right wing. He goes back to Banner, just left of center. Top of the key. Banner goes to his left. Picks up his dribble, passes to Taylor. Peck was right there. He's got three fouls. Pass to the right corner for an Oliver three. It missed. Elliott grabs the rebound for UMES. That's his eighth. Only 3 points tonight for Dominique Elliott, but he's finding other ways to be a factor. 52-50. UMES by two as they really slowly put together something on offense. Sealing on the right wing and a foul, I think, on Oliver. Sure is.
Yep, they're being consistent out front there. They're not going to put your hands on somebody above the three-point line.
That foul gives us another timeout on the floor. Still 52-50. Back in a moment. Hawks have the basketball when we return on the Hawks Sports Network.
Green light. Hey, girl. School zone. I'm getting hungry. Car changing lanes. You want to meet me for pizza? Stop sign. Intersection clear. Yeah, street. Pizza sounds good. Ball in street? Girl in street!
It's hard to concentrate on two things at once, like texting and driving. Stop the text, stop the wrecks. How will you stop texting and driving? Tell us at stoptextstopwrecks.org. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
The Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference. 13 institutions all striving as one to excel in the classroom and on the field. A premier Division I conference with 16 sponsored sports, showcasing the talents and strengths of our student athletes through hard work and perseverance. The Mid-Eastern Athletic Conference, educating for the game of life.
UMES with a two-point lead as we near the midway point of the second half. They played very well on their home floor all year, 6-1. And Dave Bird, when you've got a team like Norfolk State, you better put together a full 40-minute effort.
You're going to have to be full 40-minute effort. You're going to play defense. We're actually out shooting them from the three-point line. They're the best three-point shooting team in the conference. We're out shooting them from the free-throw line. They're the best shooting team in the country. So things are going our way, but we still only have a two-point lead with 11 and a half minutes left in this basketball.
And the Hawks have connected on 10 three-pointers. That's one shy of a season high. They've done 11 threes twice. Mark Seelan runs the point with Devin Martin, Derek Opek, Dante Caldwell, and Dominique Elliott. Seelan traveled with the basketball. He picked up that pivot foot just as he was releasing his pass.
Has it been me tonight, or has it been a lot of traveling violations?
Well, I mean, almost all of the turnovers have been travels, you're right.
That's what I thought. I'll make sure I'm correct on that.
Kind of bizarre.
I know, it's a weird statistical game, too.
Banner up top, passes to the left side. Taylor on his way to the hoop, tucks it, and finished, and one. Basket counts, Dante Caldwell got in his way. His third.
And Taylor kind of got his shoulder by the guy, you know what I mean? And then Caldwell just stepped in there, outside a little arc. Not enough. Taylor to the three-throw line.
Deshaun Taylor, the senior. He went to Garden City Community College in Kansas before transferring. He is a native of the Bahamas. Ready to go. The free throw up and good. It's 53-52, Norfolk State. 11 minutes to play. Right corner, Caldwell, catch and shoot three. You bet! 11 threes for the Hawks tonight. 55-53. UMES scampers back defensively.
Tying a season record for the Hawks.
Banner bounces into the high post. This is Taylor working on Seelan, who hands up top to Wade. Wade had just checked in for Jeff Short, and Devin Martin got in Oliver's way. He impeded his progress. Devin picks up just his second foul of the game, which is critical because he picked up that first foul 1 minute and 1 second into the contest.
I know we repeated this, but again, that foul is about 40 feet from the basket. And the referees have been calling it correctly and very, very consistent on it. So don't touch the guy out there. That's plain and simple. Especially this team who can shoot free throws.
Norfolk State's in the bonus as Andino comes back in for Derek Opek. Oliver's free throw is up and good.
For the rest of the ball game, Norfolk is shooting foul shots. This is not good.
Yeah, with 10:39 left.
10:39 left in the basketball game.
They've hit 7 of 16 tonight. After starting the first half, 4 of 13. Oliver up and good. 55-54, UMES against a press in the backcourt. Martin on the right side goes all the way to the hoop, gives off to Elliott last second. Dom, a power dribble, forced it up and was swatted away by Butler. Nicely done. Banner in the forecourt left wing. Looking around, he's got a high screen from Taylor but doesn't use it. He'll pull it back out as they run the offense. Wade runs along the baseline, ball still on the left wing. Banner dribbling around, passes into the left corner. Holding the ball, now putting it on the hard court. Working his way around Taylor, finds Butler high post. No, and the putback up and in. Actually, there's an offensive foul on Taylor, who went pushing the Hawks into the paint. Everybody from Norfolk State is on their feet and screaming, including the coaching staff. That ball had gone back up and into the hoop, and Taylor thought he got robbed. under 10 minutes left in the game.
Taylor was up there.
Tied at 55. Elliott gives back to Mark Seelan. This is where the Hawks have had trouble tonight. They have struggled when trying to slowly put together something on offense. Seelan on the left wing, 8 to shoot. Caldwell in the corner, and I think he stepped out of bounds. He sure did. That will bring Seelan back off the floor, and Thomas Rivera returns after the ninth turnover of the game for UMES. Seelan in probably his most consistent playing time all year. He hasn't played more than 8 minutes in a game all season, and he's been out there for a huge chunk of time tonight, playing 11 minutes so far with still half the second half left. Right side, holding the ball. Oliver back to an open banner. Three ball didn't fall. Elliott jumped higher than everybody else for the rebound.
Way up off the glass that time. Dominic, both hands high above the rim.
55-55. Rivera fakes to the left, passes to Caldwell. Corner three. Yes! 12 threes for the Hawks tonight, and Caldwell's got 18. 4 of 5 from deep for the young kid.
We needed somebody to step up, and Caldwell has done the job.
58-55, the Hawks have hit 12 of 24 triples. Left side, Oliver almost had it pop out of his hands. And then a foul called on Rivera, who was all over him. Thomas Rivera picks up his second. So we will have free throws, as has been the case far too often, and will be the case for the rest of the second half. Oliver, 1-1. It's up and good. And now you're seeing Norfolk State find the rhythm.
Right. They're not missing now.
No. No, now they're definitely back on track. And right on cue, Jeff Short comes back into the ballgame. And he is easily the most dangerous player for Norfolk State. Short, Taylor, Banner, Butler, and Wade against Andino, Elliott, Caldwell, Martin, and Rivera. Oliver taking his time. It's up and good. 58-57, Norfolk State has shot it much better in the second half, only missing once. Martin on the left side, passes back to Rivera, back to Martin. Now to the left corner, Caldwell's being guarded closely. He threw one away in the post. Bad pass for Elliott. Norfolk State controls. A chance to take the lead in the right corner. Oliver has it. Goes toward Taylor to a cutting teammate left corner. Wade, three, too long. Rebound goes out to Devin Martin. Devin's had a good ball game both offensively and defensively. Pulls down his third rebound here this evening. Hawks by one on their home floor. Great lob for Elliott, who's blocked at the rim. Butler went up and met the ball at its highest point. He is defending Elliott tonight, as well as any post player in the conference has all year. Oliver for three, can't finish. And Wade fouls Rivera going up for the rebound. Check that, fouls Andino going up for the rebound. Seventh foul on Norfolk State.
That's Butler's second block on Wade. That's a little surprising.
7:53 on the clock. We've got a 1-1, but first a timeout on the floor. 58-57, Maryland Eastern Shore by one, 7:53 to go. This is the Hawk Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Gary Stockbridge, Delmarva Power Region President, on ensuring reliability.
Electricity is an essential part of everyone's lives. It's a necessity, not a luxury. That's why we're investing in the communities we serve to help ensure reliable electric service. From new power lines and advanced technology to expanded customer service and energy efficient upgrades, we're working harder than ever before. This is our commitment to you. Our work continues.
Delmarva Power, online at delmarva.com.
Peninsula Regional Medical Center is proud to be recognized as a national healthcare leader, delivering exceptional healthcare by exceptional people. The professional staff at PRMC is equipped to handle most injuries and illnesses that are non-life-threatening and can deliver immediate medical attention without an appointment. To get more information and up to the second wait times, visit peninsula.org. PRMC, proud to be the official healthcare provider of the UMES Hawks.
Eastern Shore with a 58-57 lead at the 7:53 mark of the second half. The Hawks have won four straight games, some of them impressive, some of them really close contests. Those wins in succession have come against Bethune-Cookman. That was a two-point game at home. An overtime two-point win at Coppin State. A blowout win against Howard on national TV last Monday by 18. And a three-point win against Hampton who had a three-point attempt to tie the game at the buzzer, blocked by Martin. Ryan Andino to shoot 1-1, trying to add to the one-point lead. It's up, and it's too long. Rebound tipped twice, and Short comes away with it. So Andino cannot hit. The Hawks have hit 10 of 15 free throws. Norfolk State's hit 10 of 19 free throws. The Hawks 12 of 24 threes as Short tries a 35-footer and missed from the left wing. That was not a smart shot.
That was a little deep.
Norfolk State's hit 7 of 17 threes as Caldwell traveled with the ball before he went to the lane. He was a little too antsy trying to take advantage and get that extra step. Was on the left wing of the defense closing and wanted to zip around him, but couldn't do so in time. Hawks have turned it over now for the 11th time. They have forced only 7 Norfolk State turnovers. By the way, the Hawks have 29 bench points tonight, thanks in large part to what Caldwell has done with his team-high 18. Wade has it on the right wing for the green and gold, and there's a walk in the paint as he gave the ball back to Preston Bungay. 58-57 Hawks, they get it back.
Everybody in the whole building called that, baby.
That's right.
The Hawks need on offense. Devin Martin needs to touch the basketball. They've come down and not got it to him.
Rivera is one assist high, by the way, of tying a career high. One assist shy, I should say, as Elliott drew a foul as he was trying to pass the ball off in the post.
Yeah.
This one also on Bungay after he travels. He now commits a foul. And so Elliott shoots 1-1.
And now he's going to the bench.
Sure does. Deshaun Taylor back in. He tries to rally up his mates. Moses Toriola, the 6'10 Nigerian freshman forward, is back in the game as well. Elliott's free throw is good. 59-57 UMES.
That's Elliott's 8th point for the basketball game.
So one more coming here. On the way. And Elliott hits it.
He has now has 9 points and 9 rebounds.
A quiet game, but he's playing well on defense. He's had a tough night against a pretty good post player defensively in Butler. On the left side, Robinson, a jump pass into the post where Taylor steps back for a free throw, jump shot, and missed. Martin got the rebound.
Good defense by Dominic that time. Hands in the face of Taylor.
Andino, left corner three. He missed it. Martin mistimed his jump. Short grabbed the rebound in front of him. He races up the floor, goes to the right side, and pulled over Rivera. Yeah. Short knew it. He starts tapping his chest to say, my bad, guys. Yeah. While we have a quick second, let's take a look around the conference. South Carolina State late in the second half is leading Morgan State 77-69. Florida A&M 39, Delaware State 28. That game is being played between the two worst teams in the conference. Coppin State is at Savannah State, and it's Savannah State leading 36-29. And Howard leads Hampton right now 35-24 late in the first half. Hampton in danger of losing back-to-back games. Right corner, Bakari Copeland, who just checked in for Ryan Andino. Up top to Martin, three ball coming, three ball good! 63-57, what has gotten into the Hawks? 13 triples.
And Devin Martin needs to touch the basketball on the offensive end.
Devin's got his 17, back to the season average. 13 of 26 from beyond the perimeter. Taylor up top to Robinson, gets the screen, pulls up from just outside the left elbow, misfire. Butler the rebound, a power dribble, a move through the right lane, and one. Right into Dominique Elliott.
Butler's a nice player around the lane for Norfolk.
Elliott's got three, Peck's got three, Caldwell's got three, but nobody for the Hawks has four. UMES got an early foul trouble in this second half, but they've cut back on those miscues over the last several minutes. Both teams have committed 9 fouls. 63-59, Butler's free throw is good. It's now a one-possession game. 5:45 and counting here in Princess Anne. UMES has lost 23 of the last 26 to Norfolk State. Elliott has it in the high key, lobs up top, Thomas Rivera. Rivera wants some help. He gives the ball to Martin right in front of us, left wing. 10 to shoot. Devin points at the clock, goes to Rivera right side. Thomas drives the lane. He's in the corner. He's trapped. He lost the ball, and it's turned over. Norfolk State picked it up. In the backcourt, Taylor gets some help, finds Robinson. Robinson looked like he would pull up. Instead, went to the right side and now pulls it back towards the three-point line. He'll pass left side to Short. Short back to Robinson, right wing into the corner to Wade. Wade drives the baseline, puts it off the window. Friendly roll, no good. It's loose on the floor, everybody diving for it, and the jump ball keeps it with Norfolk State.
And the Hawks got a break that time. Butler lost handle on the basketball underneath the basket. But the ball remains with Norfolk State out of bounds underneath their own basket.
Both teams shooting 44-43% respectively. The Hawks just behind the Spartans. Game high 18 points from Dante Caldwell. Martin's got 17. On the other side, Short's got 16. Taylor 14, Butler 13. A lot of scorers in the ball game tonight. Robinson looks left. He'll give off to Taylor, who fakes and drives and couldn't dunk the ball. He lost it on the way up, and he's laughing at himself as he runs up the floor. Here's Martin on the right wing, up by three. Hawks with just 440 separating them from their most emotional victory of the season should they pull it off. Elliott in the left corner, working on Butler. Finds a cutting Martin, who fades away and is fouled. Devin was grabbing that right wrist. He appears to be okay as he gets to his feet. The foul is on Jonathan Wade, his second, team 10th. So the Hawks will shoot two free throws the rest of the way.
Yeah, I think we're very successful when Devin Martin, the ball goes through Devin Martin on offense. If you notice the possessions when we scored, Devin has touched the basketball or scored it for us.
He is truthfully the most all-around player on this team. I don't think it's any secret the Hawks will tell you that they need Devin to be healthy. They need him to play at his best. I think he felt maybe a little bit of perspiration on the ball, so they'll take a Gatorade towel and wipe it off. We've got 4:30 left in the game. The Hawks lead it 63-60, and Devin Martin will shoot two free throws for UMES.
Big free throws for the
Hawks.
Big,
big shots. Devin's a 77% free throw tosser. First one missed long. Martin has hit just five of, I should say, he's hit, that was his first free throw of the game. He's hit five of eight threes. I'll spit that out eventually. 6 of 13 from the floor tonight. No turnovers. Big free throw here to make it a four-point game. And he got it. Mad at himself for not hitting both.
No problem.
All right. Hawks by four. Mark Seelin back in the game for Thomas Rivera. Here's Robinson passing right side to Wade. Back to the top now in Taylor. Taylor bounces left side to Robinson. Caldwell right up on him. Up top to Short, who fakes, drives the right lane, pulls up from the elbow, missed it. Butler there for the rebound on the offensive side, and he's fouled and one. How does he keep getting underneath every Hawk every time?
He gets inside position, he gets the rebound, and he's very patient going back to the basket. You see, three white shirts are up in the air, and then he comes underneath of them for the putback. Very smart player. Around the bucket. Martin achieves a little bit.
Yeah. Martin picks up his third. Butler's got another free throw. Having a really good ball game tonight for a guy who averages just 6 points and seven rebounds. He's got 13 points and seven boards tonight, and he's been a menace defensively. He's really limited Dominique Elliott. Mark Seelin runs the point with 3:50 and counting. 64-63 UMES. Copeland in the corner looks underneath to Elliott. Finds Caldwell. Catch and shoot three. Short. Offensive rebound won't come down because the ball goes over the top of the backboard. Too bad because there were two Hawks right there, Seelin and Elliott, waiting for it. Final media timeout. It is Sweaty Palms time in UMES. 64-63. Back in a moment on the Hawks Sports Network.
Consider the cup holder. There's probably one feeling empty next to you right now. No Pepsi, no hope. Just look at it, won't you? All across the country, cup holders are being neglected. Instead of Pepsi, they're being filled with loose change or crumpled up receipts. But you can help. Get a Pepsi and refresh a cup holder's life. Our thirsts are counting on it. In fact, I'm having one right now. That is refreshing. Pepsi, refresh yourself. Refill your cup holder.
Bobby, you're here again.
Yeah, my doctor told me to reduce stress at work, so I come to Buffalo Wild Wings to eat lunch and watch sports. I get to pick one of seven entrees, like sandwiches and salads, plus one of seven sides.
Well, I like sides.
It's so affordable, I can finally take a vacation.
Where are you going to go?
Here, Tim, here.
Introducing the new B-Dubs Fast Break Lunch Menu, starting at a new low price. Dine in or order takeout weekdays between 11 and 2. Participation and availability may vary. Buffalo Wild Wings. Wings, beer, sports.
Hey, this is CN Ford, Dominic Elliott, and you are now listening to Hawk Sports Network on sfmsports.net.
Dominique Elliott is 1 point shy of a double-double.
Yeah,
he's had a whole bunch of them lately. 9 points, 10 rebounds for Elliott. He is the conference reigning player of the week. Elliott tonight has really been held in check because of the defense from Butler. Elliott's got 3 double-doubles in his last 6 games, coming off a career-high 23 points in that win against Hampton on Saturday. And he means, I would imagine he's going to play a big part here late.
I would think
the Hawks try to figure out a way to win this one.
Yeah, he's got 9 points and 10 rebounds and 3 assists. So he's had that's a decent game. He's going to go in double figures and points.
And Dino, Martin, Seelan, Elliott, and Copeland are out there. Robinson passes to Short in the corner for Norfolk State. Back to Robinson, back to Short in the corner. Up top to Wade, who's out there with Taylor, who touches it and finds Butler. Butler, one dribble, drives out of control, missed the layup, and somehow Wade was there, but he double dribbled it. Oh, man, that was lucky because Wade came through there, slicing through the defense, almost uncontested, and he double dribbled the ball.
Butler fell down, but he didn't lose it. He got a cramp, and that kind of put him on the floor.
Well, I think he kind of planted funny as Alex Long comes back in, and he's got 4 fouls. I think he was surprised he was going to shoot the jump shot and then saw nothing
open
in front of him. And all of a sudden, Seelan sort of closed down on him, and Butler tried to plant his foot trying to get around Seelan, and it just sort of gave out on him. He's okay. He's over on the bench for the moment.
They need him on the floor.
Hawks 64, Spartans 63, 3:15 to play. Martin, with a foot on the three-point arc just right of center, gives back to Bakari Copeland.
And a change of defense for Norfolk. That's a 1-3-1.
Into the corner. Elliott wants to drive. He looked for a diagonal pass, couldn't find Andino. Stepping in the way, Taylor picked it off. Goes to the left corner for an open short three. It's over the top of the rim, and a backside foul by the Hawks.
Andino with a little shove in the back.
Wasn't necessary. Copeland had the rebound.
There's 3 white shirts on that side.
Andino's second. Both teams in the double bonus. And it puts Jonathan Wade at the free throw line in a 1-point game. Norfolk State has not shot free throws well tonight as a team, as Wade's first is pure. But they are the best free throw shooting team in the country. And with that make, now 13 of 22, even though that's not a good percentage, you don't want to put them on the line and test them.
But they've only missed one this half, I believe.
Wade's second one up and good too. It's 65-64, Norfolk State, with under 3 minutes to play. Seelan, right down the middle of the floor. He's running the point at the moment. This is a big time for Mark Seelan. Picks up the dribble, finds Copeland, and then gives it right back to him. Mark against the 1-3-1 zone. Goes through the right lane, all the way to the rim. Missed the layup. Contact, but no foul. Here comes Norfolk State as Thomas Rivera comes to the scorer's table. Hawks in a man-to-man. Robinson just left of center. 2.5 minutes to play is chance of defense. Echo off the rafters. And Andino commits another foul as he bumped in. I don't know if he hit Robinson or Short, but they were both right there.
He hit both. He can't keep up with Short. Short's a little bit too quick and several inches taller. That's not a good matchup for the Hawks.
Coach Collins sensing a need to change, so Randall comes to the scorer's table as well. And I'm going to guess that Rivera and Randall are going to replace Seelan and Andino. Short at the line with a 65-64 lead. And the free throw's good. 66-64. It's Bakari Copeland and Mark Seelan that leave. Martin, Randall, Rivera, Andino, and Elliott. Taylor, Robinson, Short are the three guards out there for Norfolk. Second one does not go. Elliott rips away the rebound. Long and Wade also out there for the green and gold. 66-64 Norfolk State. They're in a 1-3-1 zone defense off to the left. Hawks trailing by two. They've got the ball. 2:10 to play. Rivera bounces to Elliott in the corner. Catch and shoot. Baseline jumper is long. Martin pulls down the rebound, and he travels on the floor before he could roll the pass to a teammate. That's a tough travel call. Devin was trying to pass it. Hawks have three timeouts left. Norfolk State has two as Derek Opek replaces Ryan Andino.
That was a pretty quick shot in that shot clock for the Hawks. Down two.
Yeah, but that's a good shot from Elliott.
Oh, Elliott.
Dominique likes those.
I wouldn't complain about that. You're right.
2 minutes to play. Hawks down by two. Robinson in the forecourt for the Spartans goes to his right. Passes back to the left-hand side. Taylor holds the ball. Waves long away. Wants an ISO on Dominique. He pulls Robinson back to the top of the arc. Robinson has the ball, goes to his left, spins around Rivera. Slips to the defense, and we've got a foul in the paint. Randall went straight up in the air with his feet set, but he was inside the semicircle. Jeff Short is walking backwards into the backcourt with his fists pumping around over and over and over again. To be honest with you, it's a little showboating. And he's drawing the ire of many here in the arena.
They got several showboats on this Norfolk team. There's still not enough. There's a lot of time left in this basketball game with only a two-point lead.
Robinson at the free throw line. 1:44 to play. The Hawks had a five-point lead at halftime. They trail by two. Robinson from the line. Up and good. Derek Opek leaves the floor. Ryan Andino back in. Right now, Dante Caldwell is on the bench with 18 points. He's hit four threes and all six free throws. A little surprised he's not out there. Now Caldwell comes to the bench, or to the scorer's table. Robinson ready to shoot it, and he let it go. 68-64, Shane Randall leaves. Two-possession game with 1:44 to go. Since the Spartans went to that 1-3-1 zone, it has bothered the Hawks, who call a timeout in the forecourt. 1:42 to play. UMES burns a timeout. They had three remaining, just a 30-second timeout. Well, if you're Maryland Eastern Shore, how do you want to play this?
Well, first place, you got to get Devin Martin the basketball. Make sure he receives it in the offensive end. And then use Dominic Elliott in the low post and a little two-man game. That's what I do. At this point, though, it shows, unfortunately for the Hawks, it shows how much they miss Frost at this point of the basketball.
Rivera is a capable guard, and he's had a nice day, but he hasn't scored. No points, 0-2 shooting, 7 assists, 2 rebounds. He shared the ball well, he runs the offense well, but Frost is the better scorer of the two. Martin inbounds to Rivera. A very widespread 1-3-1. They want to take away the perimeter game as best they can. Rivera bothered by Short. He's looking for a jump pass to Caldwell. Caldwell drives the left baseline denied. Back to Martin. Three ball left wing. Too long. Rebound tipped. Loose in the corner. Everybody going for it. It's tied up. And finally, a foul is called. Andino and Elliott were both there trying to wrap it up. Coach Collins is trying to calm the Hawks defensively as Robinson and Short raced up the floor, kind of yelling to each other. Ryan Andino just picked up his fourth foul. Unfortunately, Andino is proving to be a defensive liability. And right now, I'm not sure his offense this season has been consistent enough. He's got three threes tonight. It's only the third time all year that he's had more than 3 three-pointers in a game, and three-point shooting is what he hangs his hat on.
He's in there now to score, especially if they make these free throws.
Robinson at the line, hits the first.
Five-point game.
69-64, 1:23 to play. Here comes Bakari Copeland back in for Thomas Rivera. This is a very quiet Heights Center at the moment. I think they are sensing that Norfolk State is trying to ice the game with late free throws. The Spartans have played better in the second half than the Hawks have, no doubt. They quickly erased that five-point deficit. It was a tightly contested game throughout the middle portion, and the Spartans have controlled it late. Robinson hits another one and shushes the student section. 70-64. Martin lobs into the post. Elliott catches it while jumping, turns around, lays it in, and the Hawks call a timeout. Dominique Elliott was almost fouled as he fought through the green and gold jerseys to put it in. It's 70-66. The Hawks burn one of their two remaining timeouts.
A great pass by Martin. Great catch by Dominique Elliott. And that's the big two scoring for the Hawks. For full court pressure, getting ready to come up here now. With a minute 15 on the clock, Hawks down 4, 70-66.
So both teams gather up real quick. One timeout remaining for the Hawks. It's a full timeout. Norfolk State has two stoppages left, a 30 and a full. Robinson, Short, Wade, Taylor, and Butler break the huddle for Norfolk State. It's Copeland. Well, there were six guys on the floor. Copeland goes to the bench. Blackman, Peck, Martin, Elliott, and Caldwell out there for UMES. Full court press. Baseline inbound goes to Taylor. Remember, Derrico Peck is in foul trouble. Jump pass in the backcourt. Robinson crosses the timeline with 108 to play and gives to Short. Right back to Robinson. Four-point lead for Norfolk State. They've got the ball. Robinson with a great pullback dribble to the right side. 13 seconds to shoot, under a minute to play. Wade holds the ball. Works around to the left wing. Holding up top, gives to Short. Short bobbled at five to shoot. Well outside the arc. Stares at Martin. Passes to the corner. Robinson has to shoot. Missed it long. Rebound tipped up. And a foul on Butler, who pushed Dominique Elliott. That's a good call, because Elliott was definitely thrown off balance. And Butler is shaking his head going up the floor. But I really feel like that was the right call.
That's the correct call. Butler, for one of the few times, was behind Elliott. Most of the time, he's circled in front. This time, he was behind Elliott.
So Elliott has a chance to shoot two free throws. It's 70-66 with 43.7 on the clock. Elliott needs them both. The arena falls quiet. Dom puts it up and puts it in. Mark Blackman is called over to Bobby Collins. One possession game. Elliott, the reigning player of the week and one of two seniors on the team, spins the ball through his hands, adjusts his footing, puts it up, and buries another free throw. A double-double for Elliott. 70-68, 43 seconds to play. Robinson in the backcourt is pressure. This place is loud. Robinson in the backcourt is trying to get it across just in time of the 10-second call. Short and Caldwell and Blackman are all over there. Thrown up top to Wade. Right side now to Taylor. 12-second difference between game and shot clock as Taylor drives on Elliott. Taylor goes right into Elliott's grill as Dom puts his arm around him. The two of them got tangled up. But it's a foul on Dominique Elliott, and it's going to bring free throws for Norfolk State.
That's two seniors getting together there.
Elliott's fourth personal sends Taylor to the free throw line. Big free throws here as this place tries to get really loud. Everybody jumping on the bleachers. Coach Collins even waving his hands, trying to help out the home court advantage.
You got a rebound, this miss. Still plenty of time.
Well, they got two free throws first.
Yeah.
Taylor
still plenty
up
of time.
And good. And the Norfolk State faithful in the building cheer for their team. Blackman and Peck out. Andino, Copeland, Martin, Caldwell, and Elliott on the floor.
Three-point shooters to surround Elliott. Yeah.
71-68. This is a big free throw for Deshaun Taylor. It's a one-possession game with 26 seconds to play. Taylor up. He missed it. Rebound pulled in and lost out of bounds. Elliott and Copeland and Caldwell all went for it, and they didn't communicate well enough and lost it.
Three
guys were there. It's Spartan basketball.
Wow.
Still 24.9 on the clock. The Hawks have to let that go.
One possession game.
Elliott not happy. Everybody gets their defensive alignment. Peck to guard the inbound. He's already poked one away. Short bounces into the corner. They've got to hurry up and foul him. Peck does. Jonathan Wade will shoot free throws with 22.8.
We got just what we wanted, but we didn't corral the rebound, which is the most important thing. Now, with 22.8 on the clock, Wade shooting for Mark. Two foul shots.
A lot of the fans already starting to pile out of here as Wade hits the first free throw.
Now we have to rebound this baby right here.
Peck and Blackman leave. Copeland and Andino back out there. What might have been. Wade steps to the free throw line once more. Confidently puts it up and in. Nothing but net. Timeout, Norfolk State. They were down five at halftime, and they have built their largest lead of the whole game.
Yeah.
5 points right now, 73-68, and they take a full timeout. Well, let's take it with them. 23 seconds to play. This is the Hawks Sports Network on SFNSports.net.
Each week, go inside the athletics program at the University of Maryland Eastern Shore with Hawks Talk.
I'm Brendan Gulick, radio voice of the Hawks. And we're joined today by head coach Bobby Collins.
Hear from UMES coaches.
The one thing that we did, we played hard.
Student athletes.
Being a student athlete, obviously, student is first.
We're happy to do it in front of what is a really nice crowd here on Wednesday night at Buffalo Wild Wings on Route 13 in Salisbury. We'll be here from 7 to 8.
It's Hawks Talk from SFMSports.net on Fox Sports 960.
Gary Stockbridge, Delmarva Power Region President, on ensuring reliability.
Electricity is an essential part of everyone's lives. It's a necessity, not a luxury. That's why we're investing in the communities we serve to help ensure reliable electric service. From new power lines and advanced technology to expanded customer service and energy efficient upgrades, we're working harder than ever before. This is our commitment to you. Our work continues.
Delmarva Power, online at delmarva.com.
Hawks down five with 20 seconds to play. Martin up the floor for three. He missed it to the right. Rebound to Taylor and a foul. And that's pretty much going to do it. Norfolk State with a five-point edge is going to the free throw line to ice the ball game. Maryland Eastern Shore was down 71-68. And on a missed free throw, three Hawks went for the rebound and the ball went out of bounds. That's what everybody's going to point to in a game where the Hawks have shot a new season-high 13 three-pointers as Taylor misses the first free throw. I got to be honest, of all the teams we've seen so far this year, I think Norfolk State is the best team in this conference right now. I know the record does not reflect that yet as Taylor puts it in, 74-68. This is a very good basketball team. Martin down six across the midcourt stripe, all the way to the hoop. He is fouled hard by Butler with 9.4 left in an arena that suddenly has virtually nobody in it. And Devin is down on the floor as, to be honest with you, that was kind of an unnecessary foul by Butler.
He just landed awkward on his back. He's going to be sore.
Devin is squirming around. He's trying to get his way up.
Yeah. He's going to need several days off to make it through till Saturday, because that is a square on his back. That's going to be hurting big time.
9.4 left in regulation. Hawks down six.
Whirlpool.
Martin taking his time, trying to stretch his back a little bit. He is clearly in some pain. So he'll shoot two free throws here. Elliott and Butler having words, and a technical foul called on Butler and Elliott. A double technical. So no free throws are going to result from it. Just technical fouls issued. Elliott there trying to stick up for his classmate. Not sure what Butler was saying. I don't want to speculate on the conversation, but the two of them just didn't stop. So Martin has personal foul free throws. Butler has just, I think he's picked up, well, yeah, that's right. It is his fifth because he picked up the personal and the technical. So Butler is done. That's his fifth foul. It's a six-point game with 9.4 to go. Dominique Elliott has also fouled out. That was his fifth. So Devin Martin will go to the free throw line. Referees making sure that the game stays under control. Devin got the benefit of having the extra second to rest his back for the moment.
Right, get a breath of air.
Foul shot up and good. Martin's been another key cog in the wheel tonight. 19 points, 5 of 10 threes. He's hit 1 of 3 from the stripe. 5 boards, 2 assists. Martin's shot is up and good. Now Blackman and Peck come back on, 74-70. It's not over yet. Copeland and Martin check out. Randall, Peck, Andino, Blackman, and Caldwell. Inbounds pass coming from Long. From Taylor. They get it quickly into Robinson, and he'll come up the floor after Mark Blackman got behind him and nudged him. The Hawks appear as though they're going to lose their second home game of the year. And they will only have another crack at Norfolk State if they get them in the MEAC Championships.
They may see each other again.
Never know. Robinson from the line hit the first, 75-70. Coach Collins trying to lengthen this game as much as he can.
And Norfolk State has hit their free throws in the second half.
They've hit them when they counted, you're right.
They hit them when they counted. And
4 of 13 in the second half. In the first half. Actually, they have not missed in the second half.
That's right.
Robinson, one more. Good. No, I checked that. They've missed one time.
Yeah, but just this
one. Right, yeah, the most crucial one.
It's only
76-70. Caldwell dribbles behind his back and lost it out of bounds. That will do it. All Norfolk State has to do now is just inbound the ball.
Yeah, one miss in the second half, and that was the one that went off our foot out of bounds.
Wow. So the final score in the ball game here this afternoon, or I should say this evening, Norfolk State 76 and Maryland Eastern Shore 70. The Hawks fall to 5-5 in conference play. Norfolk State climbs to 8-2. They are a really good basketball team, and I'm telling you, look out for them come MEAC tournament time. It's going to be a fun tournament, though we've got some games to go before we get there. Still 6 games left in the regular season, and I know the Hawks are looking forward to regrouping and getting back after it with Delaware State and Howard next weekend.
Not that much difference in those teams, either.
Coach Collins joins us on our post-game show after a 76-70 loss. Coach, I want to ask you real quick, first things first, does Devin Martin appear to be okay by your eyes?
Yeah, he's fine. He took that bad shot. He's fine.
As the Hawks came down the stretch, I know the thing that everybody's going to point to is the free throw miss where there was miscommunication on the rebounding effort. Is that the